In linear algebra, we can often approach problems both from an algebraic point of view, say with variables and equations, and from a more geometric point of view. Those two viewpoints can often help each other. We can see, for example, how planes are lying with respect to each other using the underlying equations, using the normals. In this video, we'll do it the other way around. The geometric view on a linear system will tell us something about the solutions of the system, even before we start to solve it. Let's see how in this video. So, let us take a look again at our linear system. First equation, x1 minus 2x2 equals minus 1, and second equation, minus x1 plus 3x2 equals 3. And now we are going to plot all the points which satisfy the first equation in the x1, x2 plane. So if we set x1 equals 0, then we get minus 2x2 equals minus 1, so x2 equals 1/2, that's this point. And if we set x1 equals minus 1, we get minus 1 minus 2, x2 equals minus 1. So x2 has to be 0, that's this point over here. And then if we set x1 equals 1, we get minus 2, x2 equals minus 2, so x2 equals 1, that's this point. And we so on. So we can do all different points x1 and compute which x2 we get. And you see, well, it looks like those points are lying on a straight line, like this. Whoops. Is that indeed the case? Well, what we can do, we can take the first equation, x1 minus 2, x2 equals minus 1, and we can solve for x2. Then we see first, bring the x1 to the other side, minus 2, x2 equals minus 1, minus x2, and divide by the factor minus 2, we find x2 equals 1/2 plus 1/2 times x1. And as you see, that is indeed a straight line with slope 1/2, and intersecting the x2 axis at 0, 1/2. We can do, of course, the same trick for the other linear equation. We can again solve for x2. So bring x1 to the other side, then we get 3x2 equals 3 plus x1. Divide by 3, we get x2 equals 1 plus 1/3 x1. Again, we have a line now with slope 1/3, so slightly more like this. And intersecting at 0, 1. So here we have our two lines, first linear equation, the red line, and a second linear equation over here, the green line. So we see one very special point. That's the point over here. That point where both lines intersect. So it is on both lines, which means that it satisfies both the first and the second equation. But the point satisfying both the first and the second equation, that is exactly the solution of our linear system. So you can view one linear equation as points on a line, second linear equation as points on another line, and the point where both lines intersect is exactly the solution of our linear system. But that will tell us something about the number of solutions a linear system can have. Because two lines can intersect, so that means that the system has exactly one solution. Two lines can be parallel, like this. In that case, there are no points of intersection, so the linear system will not have any solutions. Or the lines can happen to be the same on top of each other. And then you have an infinite number of points of intersection, which means that you have an infinite number of solutions. And notice that if you have two lines, they can never intersect in, say, two points. So that means that a linear system can never have two solutions. Of course, we have done this for equations with two unknowns in R2, but two equations with two unknowns, but the same holds for any number of linear equations with any number of unknowns. Well, how can you see that from the augmented matrix? Well, just do your row reduction. And you'll see what happens. First of all, we look at the linear system x1 plus x2 equals 1 and 2x1 plus 2x2 equals 1. And we do the row reduction and we see what happens. Then we get an equation of the form 0 times x1 plus 0 times x2 equals minus 1. There are no x1 and x2 satisfying this equation, which means that our a linear system has no solutions. In this case, it is called inconsistent. Well, how would that look geometrically? Well, just try to plot for yourself those two lines coming from those equations. And if you do it correctly, you will observe that your lines are indeed parallel. Then second case, x1 plus x2 equals 1 and 2x1 plus 1x2 equals 1 as well. We do again one row reduction step and we observe that we find one solution. X2 equals 1 and x1 equals 0. Well, if you have a case like this with one solution, then you are in this case, where you have one point of intersection. Try this again for yourself, plot the two lines and see whether you have indeed one point of intersection. And then onto the second, the last case, the third case, x1 plus x2 equals 1, 2 times x1 plus 2 times x2 equals 2. We do again the row reduction and we get to the augmented matrix over here. And now you see that one equation has vanished. Yeah, are left with only one equation. So both equations are basically the same. So if you have only one equation for two variables, that means that only one of the variables will be fixed and the other one can be chosen freely as you will. So for example, you can choose x2 as you want and then you can only specify x1 in terms of x2. Well, if you can choose one variable as you like, and that means that you can make an infinite number of choices, which means that you have an infinite number of solutions. And that means that your lines are in fact on top of each other. And again, of course, try to plot those lines from those equations and check whether they are indeed up on top of each other. So now you see how many solutions the system has, and you also have already some feeling how you can tell this from your augmented matrix.